if you own these type of robotic cameras, like the BRC-H900, there's a good chance you don't want to sit and shade them with your standard Sony remote control. You want to use a real RCP. You want to hand over control to a different operator than the guy who controls the pan, tilt, and zoom. So the SKAARHOJ universal RCPs, they are universal, but it's almost as if they were made for these cameras, because they know these cameras quite intimately. They know exactly the range of values you can set for iris gain and shutter speed, and it knows the exact VSCA command set that they support. So in this video, we'll look at how three RCPs from SKAARHOJ will control three robotic cameras. They are connected with IP, and the camera's output are connected to a multi-viewer, so we can follow what value changes happen in the camera as we go. So the RCPs look like this, and if you haven't studied our universal RCPs, you'll quickly identify we have an iris joystick, we have a preview button, some displays that show values, identification of the camera. We have some buttons up here, and in this case, they are set up to work as a menu. So as I push these buttons, it will change which settings I have access to, and the settings are adjusted with these knobs and are shown on the display. So we'll get back to that, but let's first take a look at the iris section. So what you'll see now is, as I pull the iris handles, I'm adjusting iris of each camera in turn. You'll see the values on the displays are the values reflected on the on-screen menu as well. I'm not sure it's possible to see on the video, but there should be a perfect correspondence between these, and that kind of underlines my point from before, that the value ranges you see on the RCPs are the actual values that are documented for the particular camera we are controlling. And that's pretty neat that the RCPs know what cameras they are connected to, and they will show you the value F11, for instance, for iris, instead of some integer value that is just covering for this particular aperture. If we look at the settings section here, we have the menu selector, and as I push these buttons, you'll see how the display changes, and the values that I'm changing with the button here will also change. So now as I press this button, we'll see gamma and ni in the display. If I push this one, we have matrix settings. And if I push this one, we have detail settings. In this, we have color detail or skin tone, I think it's called for other cameras. And then finally, a lot of Boolean settings here. Sometimes you can actually push the button twice. That was not the case over here. But in the gamma menu, there's like a few extra settings that will appear like that if I push the button once more. But let's go back to the home screen. This is where the main action is, the white balance mode and the exposure mode, and zoom into that section for a moment. So in the home screen, I'm now going to turn the encoder knob for the exposure mode. So I'm going from manual to auto, and you can see in the on-screen menu the settings that are now relevant in this case. So we have AE speed, for instance. I can choose between low, mid, and high. And this is how it's reflected in the Sony BRC-H900 camera, the exposure compensation. And again, the value ranges are specific to this camera, which is clear from the display, both the on-screen menu and the one in the RCP here. Now, if I change the white balance mode, you'll see I go from manual, where I have R and B gain over here, which I can now adjust with the encoders. We need to change the on-screen menu so you can follow the color settings on screen. This is where it is. So now as I'm turning the knob for the red gain and for the blue gain, you can see these values reflected on screen. And if I change the white balance mode, you'll see that these tiles, again, they change, they adapt to the context. And if I go further to outdoor, which is an automatic mode, indoor and auto here, you see these settings, again, they reflect the relevant settings that you can also see in the on-screen menu, that speed and offset is available when we are in the auto mode, not in indoor, not in outdoor. And when I get to one push, we have the one push trigger right there. And then back in manual mode, we have access to R and B gain. So that's a pretty neat reflection of the settings that make sense in particular cases. And a really good example of how these the menu, even though the RCP is universal. It still knows your camera, and it can adapt perfectly to the settings and the value ranges that are found in that camera. We've now taken a brief look at the settings you can adjust in the Sony robotic cameras on the RCP. Or basically, we have taken a look at what we implemented in the menu, and that was a selection that felt relevant to a particular RCP operator. But the fact is, you can basically adjust any parameter, and it's all a matter of configuration. Now, if you buy our RCP and you want to work with a Sony robotic camera, I can guarantee you that it will work out of the box quite easily, actually, because we have default profiles that mean that even though our hardware is so flexible, you still, you know, just start out by selecting a default profile that will work with this camera. So let's take a look at the configuration that made this possible. What you basically do is to press the online configuration button in the SKAARHOJ firmware updater utility after connecting it using the USB cable supplied with the RCP. And it will open a web page. And on this web page, you see the specific configuration for your SKAARHOJ controller. Now, in this case, we are actually running on a default configuration. As I said, this configuration is programmed by us. It's set up to give you out of the box functionality that with the RCP that works with these cameras. So it's really easy. But let's say that we wanted to change something, like we want to see how is the iris handle implemented. So what we can do is to just click the iris handle. You see on this drawing, we have the iris handle right there. And I'll now click it, and it will scroll down on the page, and it will show us how the joystick has been set up. So in fact, you can see there's a drop-down box here. And if I press this drop-down box, you see almost... Yeah, basically, you see the complete set of commands you can select for the Sony BRC-H900 camera. And obviously, we have selected iris. So when I pull the handle, you will see the iris value in the camera changed. If I wanted to adjust shutter speed in this way, we could just select shutter speed, and now the handle would adjust the shutter speed in the robotic cameras. And likewise, if I wanted to adjust, let's take something like matrix color, because behind this setting, a lot of more levels are hidden. So basically, I say, okay, matrix color, and then you'll see you have this drop down that will give you access to the color level, which is basically saturation, the hue, the RG, RB, and all these dimensions you can adjust. So this is a really good example of how the Unisketch interface will allow you to tweak your controller to do it exactly the way you prefer it, instead of the default profile that we provided, which will help you getting started really quickly, but you can always get it exactly as you want. And that's the secret about any SKAARHOJ product you will enjoy in the future.